Hi, Alan Stratton from As Wood Turns. I'm preparing to do an experiment with my threading jig, and I had a particular problem with it, and I took it to a Saturday event we had for our club with other wood turners, and several of them are machinists, and showed them the situation, my potential solution, and left them alone for a bit, and they came up with something radically different. What it was is I needed a flange nut. Well, what's a flange nut? I had to look that up, but essentially a flange nut is a regular nut, but with an extra integrated almost washer and a little bit thicker and a little bit fatter. And then I was to drill and tap and put a brass set screw in the side of the flange nut to be able to hold a shaft in a particular position. Well, I checked the pricing on 1x8 flange nuts, and they are expensive and rare. So then I said, okay, what do I do? And finally I had an epiphany. I have a tap for a 1x8. This is a Beal tap. And I have high-density polyethylene. And this application really does not have to have steel. It's low stress. So why not make my own flange nut out of polyethylene? Then as I thought about it, well, I need a round part and a hexagonal part. How do I do that with my equipment? Because I don't have a mill. And finally I said, well, what's the essence of what I need? All I have to do is make a bigger, thicker, fatter nut. So this is a 1x8 nut out of polyethylene. I tapped it and put in a brass screw. I could not buy set screws locally, and I mushroomed the head out to give me, in effect, a thumb screw. I'll show you how I did it. What's it for on the threading jig? Well, I'll show you that later, if indeed it does work. But for now, let's make this replacement flange nut.
Maybe on a bowl I can wing it for the design. That is not the case here. I attempted to draw in PowerPoint, then switched to CorelDRAW to get the accuracy that I need. I especially need the outside lines, the center mark, and the mark for the middle of a side. I used contact adhesive to fasten the full-size paper pattern to a 1-inch thick high-density polyethylene. I rough cut the HDPE to get rid of the excess material. I worked with a pattern maker who never tried to cut exactly to a line. Instead, he would cut up close, but never at the line. At the disc sander, I sanded each side flat and close to the line. Since I do not need exact tolerances, I stopped when the sides were smooth but still shy of the line. It turns out that sanding 1-inch high-density polyethylene with a dull sanding disc is tough going. Now at the lathe to tap the nut. I center punched the nut and pressed it against a threaded wood faceplate with double stick tape. I am concerned that the torque of threading would overwhelm the double stick tape with the small sticking area. I cut small scraps of OSB. Since the faceplate is wood, I can screw the scrap around the nut to resist the torque. The 1-inch Beal tap specifies a 7/8 inch pilot tap hole. I'm drilling that next. The HDPE streams off nicely. I'm catching the stream to avoid mixing it with the sawdust on the floor. To thread, I'm mounting the tap lightly in the pilot hole and held with light tailstock pressure. Then I move the tool rest to hold the spindle lock. Then I'm rotating the tap with a wrench while advancing the tailstock. The HDPE cuts easily. While still mounted to the faceplate, I'm using a skew to cut a chamfer at the start of the threads to make starting the nut easier. Then remove the OSB and clean off the double stick tape. Now for the side hole for the set screw. The pilot tap hole is 13/64 diameter. I use the pattern to align the piece on the drill press. Across the thickness of the nut, exact placement is not required. To tap the 1/4 inch hole, I put the tap in my drill at low speed, then ran the tap in and out of the hole as slowly as I could. Excellent! Worked great! Then I tested the threads with a 1/4 inch bolt. I need a nylon or brass set screw, since it will be pressing against threads. Steel would mar the threads. However, I could not find brass set screws locally. I purchased a brass bolt and plan to hammer this head into sort of a thumb screw. I don't know all the safety considerations for this work, but at least I'm wearing my full face shield. I have nuts on the threads of the bolt to protect the threads. I'm holding the bolt with nuts with vice grips. I have a short piece of railroad track for an anvil and a typical framing hammer. Then I'm hammering for the brass bolt head into a flat half oval. This may work better than a set screw, since I will not need an Allen wrench to tighten it. Finally, I thread the 1-inch tap into the hole again by hand to clean up the threads. I'm amazed. My shop-built flange nut substitute seems to be perfect. It is not exactly what my wood-turning buddies specified, but it is what I could make with the tools I have available and without the expensive specialized flange nuts. This is a component to an experiment with my threading jig. I'll let you know later whether my experiment actually works. This oversized nut was easier than I thought and fun to make. Please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe on my website, tell your friends, and send me your comments and questions. Every week I make a new wood turning video. Please wear your full face shield. Goggles are not enough protection. Until next week's video, this is Alan Stratton from As Wood Turns.